TFCCert and FEST for having me here. As you said, I'm going to talk about a cybersecurity emergency plan that we have started with our local entities in our region. First of all, a really quick introduction of who we are. We are CSIRT-CV, that is the cybersecurity center of the regional government in Comunitat Valenciana in Spain. Our constituency includes everything that exists in the region, but mainly we have always been focused on the regional government. That is where we reside organically and where we have the most services. Where we always have had the most services for them. And the other public administrations, businesses, and citizens, we have had some services, but very few services for them. Related to the topic of today, the first attempt we had to work more closely with municipalities was this virtual SOC definition that and the test pilot we started in 2018. This was a very little test pilot project that we had with only 10 participants, then 10 municipalities, and we tried to to be very, very ambitious, but the test pilot, we couldn't have many more participants within this program. So in the first quarter of 2021, we had a ransomware pandemic. The pieces of news are in Spanish, but 20 city councils, City Council of Castellón, of Xixona, another municipality, Manises, Leliana, and many other incidents that we had to attend during the first quarter of 2021. So with the previous experience and this ransomware pandemic, we put up a cybersecurity emergency plan. This plan was an emergency contract that is a special kind of public of public contract that we can do in a short time and for a very limited time scope. And it was awarded to S2 Grupo, to the same company that is working in CSIRT-CV. It will last, the contract will last for a year. It started in July 2021 and will end in June 2022. And the main objectives were these three that you have here. Deploy tools to protect the municipalities, mainly to protect them from ransomware, but from other kinds of cyber attacks too. Deploy sensors and prepare them so that the impact of future cyber attacks is minimal. So, what is the how big is this action plan? We at Comunitat Valenciana, we have more than 5 million citizens in 542 municipalities. So as we had to separate them, to give different types of services to each of them, we came to these four different types of municipalities, the micro ones that are the ones with less than 1,000 inhabitants, the small ones with 5,000, the medium ones less than 20,000, and the big ones with more than 20,000 inhabitants. For the sorry, for the micro ones, the smallest of them, as per being the smaller, they don't have a lot of TI infrastructure. So what we did was install, what we planned was to install MicroClaudia, that is a tool from CSIRT-CV, the national, one of the national CERTs in Spain, that I will talk about it later on. We send them some generic instructions to review and check their backups, and prepared some training and some generic training and awareness courses, cybersecurity training and awareness courses. I say generic because at this level, the municipalities probably don't even have a specific person for IT. Most of the times, it is someone that has other tasks and also does the IT part, or is a private company that is paid for, let's say, 3 hours a week of work managing the DTA infrastructure. The small municipalities, we had also MicroClaudia. We started with them a procedure review. We did a external visibility check every quarter. And as this year, and as some of these municipalities start having some TI managers, where we added some specific training, cybersecurity training and awareness courses for this TI manager. Medium-sized municipalities, we add on top of the previous services, the verification of backups, the focus on remote administration services. Many people starting with COVID had to access from home, and most of them published things in a not so secure manner. So we focused on those remote administration services. And also installed an endpoint agent, a Gloria agent, another CCN-CERT tool on all computers. And for the bigger ones, we planned an online reputation check service, and also for the 15 the 15 bigger ones, we plan to install a sensor on their networks called Carmen, also another CCN-CERT tool, to install this sensor on their network, so we can better detect and respond to incoming threats. Apart from us, from CSIRT-CV, we had the external support, as I said before, of CCN-CERT, also of S2 Grupo CERT, the CERT of the company that was awarded this contract, and also we had the support of the recently created National SOC Network. Okay, that was created also last year, and this. And CSIRT-CV is in charge of its development. Sorry. The National SOC Network, as I said, is provided by CSIRT-CV and the other national CERTs and its objective is to bring all the actionable intelligence together of all kinds of CERTs, public administration, law enforcement, and private sector. And with this cybersecurity emergency plan, what we aim is to be the first region in Spain that includes its municipalities inside this recently created national SOC network, thanks to this emergency project. Okay, I just showed you the main services, but another another interesting point of view is the tooling challenges. Okay, because as I said before, we use CCN-CERT tooling extensively. I don't know if you can see my my mouse, but on the top part of the slide, we have five tools from CCN-CERT. They have many more, but these are the ones that are relevant for what I want to express. And the bigger box in the center is the tooling that we have at CSIRT-CV. Our main our CM, our main source of alerts and of incidents is the CCN-CERT tool called Gloria, that is connected to the CCN-CERT tooling through Lucia, so that the incidents we investigate travel all the way up to CCN-CERT and they can see and collaborate with us if needed. Other tools that we use are, for example, Reyes, that is the intelligence hub of CCN-CERT, and Iris, that is a situational awareness portal. Okay. Okay, as I said before, the first tool we deployed, the first part of our plan was to deploy MicroClaudia. And this was a tough challenge because MicroClaudia, until that moment, only existed on CCN-CERT side. Our instance was the first to collaborate or to be federated with this CCN-CERT instance. It is federated, so we can have the same set of rules and we can share the alerts with them. The alerts also come to our main incident management console. Sorry. And as I said before, we distributed the agent to the municipalities, so they can all be connected together. The second tool that we deployed is another Gloria server that would be in place for the Gloria agents that I told you before of the medium and big sized municipalities. So the computers on those municipalities, we install them the Gloria agent and they communicate to here. We chose to put a different instance. So so we have a separate, let's say, separate silos for different kinds of events or of alerts. This a silo for the municipality's events and another silo for the regional government alerts. And last but not least, we plan to deploy several Carmen sensors on the municipalities. And as with the other tools, they connect to the central Carmen instance at CCN-CERT to gather alerts and intelligence, and they connect to our Gloria instance so we can detect all the alerts and work in a single management console. So passing to how has it gone so far? The work plan is as follows. In July, right after the contract was awarded, we started designing the procedures, analyzing the architecture that I just showed you, training the initial team that was had to do the first contact with the municipalities, and buying all the hardware that was needed. In August, we started contacting with the municipalities, had the server or the MicroClaudia server installed, had the Gloria architecture, the analysis of the Gloria architecture, and decided everything that we had to put in place, and created an initial set of indicators. This is part of the initial set of indicators, in which you can see in the top left part the actuations, that is the phone calls or the emails that were sent in the initial phase of contacting all the municipalities, because this is a regional government plan, and we have to contact each one of the municipalities, and some of them say, hey, it is okay with me or no, call me in October or whatever thing. And on the top left, the number of municipalities involved in each one of the provinces and each one of the sizes that we have. So, sorry. I had this was supposed to be okay. In September, we had all the Gloria servers installed and configured. The Carmen machines, the sensors that had to be deployed, were received, and we started pre-configurating them prior to sending them to the municipalities. There was a new service added to the pool of services, a password leak services for all of the municipalities, not just the big ones. This service was provided by CCN-CERT, and it was provided through an agreement that CCN-CERT has with threat status, with this Trillium service that so far has been working very, very well. Also, we sent an IT questionnaire to ask for the for certain things that the municipalities have, and set up the online reputation service. In November, we had the first Carmen sensor deployed to a municipality, and we had not only the Gloria machines installed, but the configuration done and the use cases that we're going to detect through these tools finished. On January, the Gloria agent deployment has started, and we achieved a milestone that is 70% of municipalities have MicroClaudia deployed. This month, we plan to finish defining the training paths for this type of municipality, and our CM and online reputation services are growing as more agents and devices are deployed on these two services. So how is it going for the MicroClaudia deployment? We have these numbers on the lower part of the slide. Under deployment, there are 428 municipalities, and pending deployment, 156. That is more or less the numbers that I said before. We had, as I said before, also with MicroClaudia, we had another additional problem, that is, there were some municipalities that already were connected to the CCN-CERT MicroClaudia instance. So we have them detected here. You can see in the in the middle part of the slide, Alta and CCN, those that were on already on CCN service, but that we are bringing to our instance, so we have all the information together. If we separate by the three provinces that form our region, these are the numbers. As I said before, on January we had 70%. We have right now 74% of municipalities with that have started deploying MicroClaudia. Sorry, some more KPIs. Apart from the number of municipalities, we wanted to know we called it the depth of those deployments. So we on this IT questionnaire, we asked at every municipality, hey, how many computers do you have? How many computers you are going to install this MicroClaudia agent on? So with those numbers and the numbers we were seeing in the platform, we built a KPI that tells us that in those municipalities that have provided us depth information, we have almost between 50 and 60% of depth achieved. So we can see that the deployment is ongoing, is still in progress. The password leak service, as I said before, we provided this service with the Trillion application from threat status, thanks to an agreement with CCN-CERT, and we have received nine alert bulletins that resulted in 224 municipalities notified and 4,521 accounts which were present in those notifications. Sorry. So to sum up, we have all the services the municipalities it applies to. As I said before, external visibility, Gloria agent, and Carmen, and online reputation were applied only to medium, to small, medium, and big levels of to small, medium, and big municipalities. So the numbers are different. The not apply can refer to multiple things. I mean, this is not necessarily a bad thing. It can be that we haven't found a contact, that we haven't get to an agreement. Some of them, very few, also said that they do not want to participate in this project, even after knowing that it is free for them. That is something, well, I don't understand very much, but they didn't want to participate. And there are others that already have those same services subscribed with other providers. They already have some of these services, so they didn't want to participate. So to sum up, we think there are lots of benefits for the municipalities, because this results in an improvement of this cybersecurity baseline. This allows for a creation of a trusted network of contacts, not only from the municipalities to us, to the CSIRT-CV, but between them, also because we have a centralized incident notification platform, we can have perimeter assessment of most of them. We can we provide better backup procedures that help them be more resilient in the case of a cyber attack. this plan allows them to have a better ENS coverage. ENS is the national norm for public administration, the national cybersecurity norm for public administration, and also it's the starting point for the municipalities to ask for Europe's recovery funds. In Spain, the recovery funds have some prerequisites that you have to accomplish in order to be able to ask for these funds, and cybersecurity is one of the main pillars that they need to have or to be part of or have some sort of cybersecurity services or be part of a cybersecurity network to ask for these funds. For us, for CSIRT-CV, it's also beneficial because we have a unified management, we have our capacities improved because of the group of people that comes with this contract, and because we have some more tools that we can use. We have an independent input channel, and we can have some synergies between our main project and this cybersecurity emergency plan for municipalities. So that's all for me. Thank you very much. And if you have any questions, please feel free to ask. Or if you want, you can contact us through our website or mail or social networks or whatever you want.
There is one question that popped up. I think Lionel Ferret asked, what's going to happen in, you know, whenever this 1 year contract runs out? So what are your plans going forward? And I'd like to add, so is this going to be expanded across Spain? Are there other municipalities looking at this and saying, that's really cool, how do we do this in our space? If you can keep this one quick, because we're late already, but I would like to know those if you can.
Yes, just really quick. We are also in the process of publishing the next contract for CSIRT-CV. So in 1 year or 1 year and a half, when this project ends, is when the CSIRT-CV project is due to end. So in the next CSIRT-CV project, this will be integrated as a core part of the CSIRT-CV project. So they will not be left behind.
Yeah, it looks like they've done an awful lot of work in a very short period. It would be a shame if they'd all disappear. And are other areas looking at this? Is there other?
I'm sure there are other areas looking at this, because we presented these very same presentations in December in an event in Spain, and some other regions approach us. So I think they might find it beneficial, and they will apply something similar to what we have applied here.
Yeah, it's very cool. I'm impressed. Okay. Anyone else? Any questions before we move on? Thank you very much, Jose. That was really interesting. It's really interesting to see municipalities getting.
Thank you very much, Chris, and everyone.